stuff.
There, I found them. This is the inventory I bought in the 90s. I never put away yet. It's not in the system. These were 80 cents a piece from Sport and Custom. Is there a date on this? No, there's a phone number though. Usually a date somewhere. These are from the 90s. Maybe from the 80s. These are old. This shit's probably from the 80s.
I'm sure, man.
So anyway, we don't care. We have the incorrect spring, and then we have a correct spring. There you go. $5 each now.
Right on. Inflation, man.
Inflation. Storage fees are astronomical around here. See, one of these days I'm going to put this shit in the computer so I can sell it. Meantime, I just go digging through the box until I find what I'm looking for, because I have a whole bunch of weird crap in these boxes. So where's your old one?
That one goes here and there.
So there's the good one. And there's the bad one. I see a slight difference. What about you?
Big time.
And the other problem is actually going to fit inside this generator or not, because that was the other problem. See, these things are not made to fit in here.
Well, this one's thin right there.
It didn't fit either. Yeah, see, these aren't fitting in here. Because this brush plate is bogus. Bogus brush plate.
Yeah, because this is a lot thinner, too.
You know, these springs are bogus. Find out. You can get a different brush plate. Okay, I grabbed another plate. Same problem, but once you get it all the way in there, it has springiness in it. So let's try that again.
But these are different diameters. You see, this one's thinner. We should use the thinner ones.
Yeah, but we don't have thinner ones.
Yeah, this one came out of the back. This one here.
Got two of them or one of them?
Got one.
That's right. Once it gets in there, it's made to be in there thicker.
This one's gonna go in. This one's really thin.
There you go. Looks fine. So if you look how these are made, they're bowed out right here on both sides, but not in the front, so the spring won't fall out. But once you're in there, see, it works fine. Not that one. The other one.
Which one?
The big one. See how it's bowed out right here?
Mm-hmm.
That's where the spring is supposed to be, not out there. So that way the spring doesn't fall out.
Oh, I see.
So you have to kind of roll it to get it in there, screw it in, whatever, mm-hmm. Once you had it. But once it's in there all the way, it's fine.
Yeah. Gotta go back.
For the old broken brush, I have to use it for a tool. See how it works now? It's got springs?
Yeah, sweet.
Yeah. There you go. Something that doesn't fit actually works correctly when you do it that way. So now when you put the new brush in there, see, it's tension just like it's supposed to. And the spring won't come out past this point because it's bigger than what the holder is. That's how it's made. Figured out. Okay, now next problem. Let's see Here's locking pressure to hold this in, which I don't like because these are supposed to be held in. That's what how it works. When they don't stay put, it's bad. So we gotta clean the goop out of the hole here. Bearing hole's clean. Take a little bit of the good shit. Mm-hmm. We could use red. Or we can use a real good stuff, green. Put that on there like that. Put a little red stuff right on here. Call it lubricant. Slips together. Which parts?
Right there.
Not supposed to grind on a cover. Housing on the back here.
Mm-hmm.
Seems to be good. One loose gear. Look how tight that is. Terrible. Okay, need some red Loctite. Red.
They're all red. Anyone?
No, they're not all red. That one's red. I put red on the nut so the nut don't come off. You want it's open? It's not red, it's green. This one's red. No wonder I got no room up there. I got multiple bottles of the same thing. This one has the same problem as the last bottle, red. This is anti-red. Clog up mode utensil. It works. You wipe off the red. It's good to go for another time. See, so we put that where you always get to it. Not that I've ever had to do that before. First time. Ooh, that's a little bit too much red on there. Soak up some excess stuff we don't need. All right, tighten that up. So you're using, you got a nut, you got a washer, you got another washer. How many washers do you need? Why don't we just go with one washer? I'm thinking one washer is all you really needed here. We don't need two washers on that. Where's your wrench? That tight? Look at that. Appears to be working.
Nice.
At one time there was grease inside that hole, but not today. Go down and find me some grease.
What do you keep in?
Down there in the grease department. Up on the shelf, Bob, to your left. That's not your left, that's your right. Over here.
Are these bottles here?
Is there any grease in there?
Yeah.
Just say grease? Good. Ooh, that has grease in there. Look at that. So you take a flat blade screwdriver. What's this?
Grease.
Grease. What's this?
Spent.
It's bearing that needs grease. So we'll go ahead and put it in there a little bit. What's in there now?
Grease and a bearing.
That's a lifetime supply of grease. All right, we're almost done. Now we got to assemble this thing. Now you didn't take that stud out, so we either have to fight this or we got to take that stud out. Which way you want to go?
Which side?
The one that's in the way. The one that's on this side. Or we got to put this over here like this. You got to make sure this wire goes up through here, but does not short against anything. So it goes there nice and cleanly like that. See, we have an indent right here. We also have a pin over here that matches a notch on that side. So the notch goes here to there. That means this stud here is the one that's in the way. Now these unscrew, or are they pushed in? These are pushed in right there. So if you knock these out, if they'll come out, it makes it easier. Or you just do it by yourself like this. So you take your fingers and go like this. You can also put zip ties around these. You can hold these brushes in like that. Okay, which side are we on? Where's my mark? I want the mark right over here.
What is it?
I want the mark right here. Now these two studs go through these two big holes here. See, once you're on the armature, you're fine. Here we go. Here's the notch at. Right there's the notch. Usually just fall right together. That one went tight. Now when you're all in here, you want to make sure the brushes do not hit up against the armature in there. You got the shoulder here on the armature. You want to make sure the brushes aren't jammed against it. See that in here?
Mm-hmm.
You also make sure they're not above the surface here running off. You want to make sure this here is not going to get jammed up on this and go like this. So like bend the things that are not rubbed on anything. And you don't want to be rubbing against the thread because that'll cut them. The shank is a lot easier on the parts. Now this here is somebody put some grease in here. See that notch right there? Where's it go?
You're asking me?
Yeah.
Here.
It goes right here where that notch right there is. These two big holes go through those two big holes.
Mm-hmm.
And that should just slide together like that. Yours fits together pretty snugly. Most of the time they just fall together, but there you go. Okay, now where is your strap? There goes your nut. So there's your strap. There's your two nuts. Nice holding stand right there, those terminals.
Like that.
Yeah. Pretty good, huh?
You got that.
How much torque did I put on that?
Enough.
That was enough? You sure? What if I want to torque it more? Pretty tight. Yep, those are good. That was my torque wrench. You like that?
Yeah.
You know, so I knew how to use it just right. Do you notice they were equally torqued too?
Sweet.
Well, you think you're done, don't you? Okay, now you take it and spin it, see if it actually spins. It makes noise one way, quiet the other, because this is the way it rotates. This isn't the way it rotates. Now, sometimes these get tight in here. If they do, just go like this, it easily frees them up. Centers up everything. So, okay, this one appears to be working. Okay, how do you test it? Here's your gauge. Amp gauge.
Amp?
Amp gauge. I don't know where it's at.
Oh, it's right here somewhere.
Oh, it's right here where all these wires are at. Put a zip gun in the way. Who did that? Here's the official generator testing device. It's called an amp gauge. It goes plus and negative. Negative bad, positive good. We have one wire that goes on the armature. And we got one wire that goes on the battery. So the one with the eyelet on it goes to the terminal over here. It's supposed to have a big A right here that you can't see. There's supposed to be an F over here for field. So you can kind of see the F a little bit. So you take your armature wire and you hook it on that. You take your jumper wire and you short this to ground. Then you start your bike up and you find out what happens. Now, first thing I do, I take this, I touch the positive terminal on the battery, make sure it goes negative. If it's going positive when you short it, you got it backwards, reverse the two wires. So, did you ever test that like I told you to? Just go zap, zap, yeah, against the battery and make sure it goes negative?
Yeah, it did.
Now, you don't hold it there.
Yeah.
You just touch
just
it.
Just for a second, yeah.
Yeah, not even see, just touch. Just goes just that quick, and it goes doop, because it's a dead short. If you hold on too long, it'll burn the piss out of you, so don't do that. Notice how this gets melted?
Right.
I don't know what happened there. Okay, so now after the bike starts up and run, then you go ahead and touch this to your positive terminal on your battery. And anything above idle, this thing should be going positive. So, but you make sure you ground the field out over here to ground. You have to ground the field. Okay, so once you get this thing running a little bit, about 1200 RPM, this thing should be putting out about 5 to 10 amps. You rev it about 1800 RPM, this thing should be putting out 18 to 22 amps. If you have to rev it up to 2,500 or 3,000 to get it to do anything, it's bad. I don't care if it does show 15 or 30 amps, it's bad. It only goes up to 22 amps, 23 max. If it goes above 23, it's bad. So you rev it up, it should come up to your whatever number it's going to be at. Most of the time it's around 21 to 22. You rev it up a little bit there. By 1,800, it should be at that point. If you rev it up to 3,000, it should still be at that point. If you rev it up to 5,000, it should still be at that point. It shouldn't keep going up higher. So, and once you come back down, it should drop right back down to zero, and at a very, very low idle, it'll go negative a couple amps because it's still putting out a little bit of power. And you just barely touch the throttle, it'll go right back positive. That's what you want to see. Yours, remember, you had to rev it up pretty high to make it do anything? That was bad.
Yeah, that's right.
Okay, then after you're all done, shut the motor off, then disconnect all this, hook up your regulator, and go see if it actually works on the bike. We know the generator's putting out power, now it's just a matter of the regulator. Now, after you get it on the regulator on the bike, you can turn on your headlight, and just above idle, the headlight should get brighter, and at low idle, it should go dim, and it should brighten up a little bit. Or you can put a voltmeter across the battery. If you see it move at all and above the 12-volt range, it's working. I don't care if it only moves a quarter of an amp. If it just moves, it's working. If it doesn't do a damn thing except vibrate, it doesn't work. Then your regulator is bad. Change it. I don't care if it is brand new. It's bad. Because when these are shorted out, it shorts out everything in the system. The generator takes out the regulator takes out the generator. So that's how you do all your testing. All right, so that should work right now, but until you put it in the bike, we don't know for sure. But it should work. 9 out of 10, they work perfect now.
Right on.
I don't have a stand to spin that thing up at 2,000 RPM and hold it and see if it works. You want to hold on to a 2,000 RPM generator? See if it spins.
We can try. Let's build one.
I'll pass.
Let's build the base for it.
It's called a motorcycle. Go build a bike, put it on it. It works great. It holds it and everything. So there you go. So make yourself a Sportster so you'll have a test stand. It could be a Panhead, though, if you want. You can have a Sportster. We can have a Panhead test stand, a 62, right? We can make a 62 generator test stand.
Yeah,
we should. Your bike.
Yeah.
We can take your bike.
Yeah.
How much for that generator test stand? Just have a GM's part number on it.
10 grand.
All right. There you go. That's how you rebuild a generator.